Hello, welcome to Airing Out. I'm Josh.
And I'm Jonas.
And this is Jerry. And today, we are going to be doing our music quiz part
two.
That's four.
It's two twos.
It's four.
But it's two and two.
Okay, let us know in the comments. Is that two or four?
Quick maths.
2 + 2 = 4 minus one, that's three.
Exactly.
So, today, we are going to be using my repeat rewind playlist, which means it's songs that I listened to or we listened to on repeat.
We just go with
more forcibly than others.
Yes. In the past.
In the past. So last time we did our songs that we're kind of listening to currently. And this is stuff.
I'm not sure about that. Some of them were.
Yes.
Not really.
No, there's stuff that kind of comes up that we were very surprised by.
Mm-hmm.
I think this playlist is better. I've not looked at it since our last video, because it was when we made that, and I was like, oh, actually, the Repeat Rewind's a better playlist.
Mm-hmm.
But I haven't looked at it since then, because I didn't want to get, like, a leg up.
Another leg up from all the legs you already have up.
Two.
in this challenge.
Two.
Yeah, guys, counting is definitely one of my strong suits.
Sure.
Yeah.
But yeah, hope you can play along. Again, the audio is the same as last time. It seemed to sound fine. If it sounds terrible,
Let us know.
Nothing I can do about it.
No, that's fair.
But we'll be doing this, play along. Doing the same thing, pausing the song when we think we know we've got it.
Mm. Getting ready.
Yeah, I put a jumper on. I was like, it's a bit chilly in here. Then as soon as there's two people and a PC running, it heats up pretty quickly. So.
Yeah.
Oh, well. Jonas just, if you could see what he's got, woolly socks on.
Yeah.
Shorts and then a big thick jumper, so I'm not quite sure what's going on here, but
yeah, because it's a shorts kind of weather, but
still quite
it's not warm enough for like just shorts and t-shirt.
Right.
Yeah.
Moving on.
I don't know, this jumper doesn't make me feel warm, like this is just
even that, like a zip over.
Yeah, but you are just like very different kind of temperature. Like,
I don't know what's going on. Yeah. Okay. I got jeans on and shoes and stuff.
Yeah. No, that's totally. Yeah, I get that. But that's like also you're not wearing shorts.
Yes, the shorts. That's the.
Have I ever seen you wear shorts?
Probably not.
I don't think so.
I've got one pair for like sport, which I think are like mountain bike shorts, and then obviously boardies when I windsurf.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah.
So, that is definitely. Yeah, no. I'm very sure I've never seen you wear shorts.
Hmm. I've like pulled my. Sometimes, you know, it's really hot, you like pull your pajamas up to your knees.
Mm hmm. Yes, that's true.
And you're like, But. Because pajamas are light anyway. Yeah. I don't have like pajama shorts, that'd be weird. Then I just wear boxers or.
That's true. Very revealing.
Well, yeah, in here, though, not in the living room. It's like,
just,
I mean, to be fair, it gets hot in our living room. Like,
yeah, no, that's exactly why I wear shorts, because I spend most of the day in the living room where we have the sun coming
straight through.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Right, shall we get on to the challenge?
Song one.
Yes.
Yes. So okay. We're looking this way, because it's going to show up here, but it should be too small for you to see, but then it means we can check.
Yes, it's definitely too small for us to see, but maybe they
yes.
can.
Yes, I know, I don't think they can see it. Probably not. If you can,
do guess along though.
Avert your eyes.
Yeah.
You ready?
Just, okay, I'm ready.
Jump on the ground. Jump, 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 jump. Moving all around. Da da da. Da.
We need more hardcore. On the ground.
Da,
no.
Da, da. Moving all around.
You know
jump,
it.
Jump, jump, jump. I don't know this song.
This is one of your nightcore.
I don't listen to nightcore music.
Yeah,
jump,
you do.
Moving all around.
I won't know. I won't be able
stamp on the ground.
Stamp on the ground?
Yeah. I have no idea who sings that. Shall we check?
This is one of your nightcore stuff.
It's one of my
nightmare. Honestly, it started off with a yeah, and I thought like this is like the
the 20th century Fox theme I never listened to in my life. Is that even a song?
I'm sure it is. Maybe just like as short as the clip is.
Honestly, I'm not sure who
it literally
makes this
just,
song.
Says
it just says
nightcore. So basically, I guessed it because it is nightcore.
I mean,
the
original is done by Italo Brothers, maybe? Who knows?
Italo Brothers.
Is this the same song? Oh my word!
Oh.
I mean, that's the same song.
In every nation.
Okay.
Okay.
Fair, I can get on board with that. Okay, so Italo that's Brothers. The Italo Brothers, but the Nightcore remix. Because sometimes you gotta put some fast music on, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
I guess for those of you that don't know, Nightcore music is pitched higher and sped up.
Or maybe it is pitched higher because it is sped up.
Yeah, although some, if they do it well, it's not quite as high.
That's true.
Like they pitch it down, I guess, from when it's sped up. Because otherwise it's just weird. but yeah, no, it's a...
Yeah, no, it's definitely where you get...
It's an acquired taste.
I guess techno is in the 140 beats per minute range, and I think Nightcore pushes it to, like, 160.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's...
But it's nice if you, like, gotta get pumped and get some stuff done.
Oh, yeah. Isn't that also in your, like, skiing playlist?
It is all in my skiing playlist as well, because, like, so my playlist is split up, so all my ski playlists are about 10 minutes of really fast music, 50 minutes of slower, more chill music, so that on the ski lifts, so I can, like, I mean, obviously it doesn't sync up quite perfectly all the time, but it means I've got, like, fast going down the black runs and then chill going up the chairlifts, just having a wee thing. So yeah, I've got some fast music for, like, skiing, which of course we never went on, but next year,
sadly.
That playlist will be just fine next year.
It will be just as good.
Yeah, and I usually make my own Spotify playlist as well, which means this is why I don't know really what's on this.
Oh, fair.
Because I will just listen to playlists I make instead.
All right, let's go.
Moving on.
Yes, very famous song.
Is it playing? Hang on. There we go. Oh, it's playing off YouTube.
Oh.
Will that work? Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Next song.
Oh, Mask Off?
Trying to put you in the worst mood.
The Weeknd.
What's that called?
Starboy.
Yeah! Fucking Starboy. Nice, well done.
Thank you.
Nice, nice. Oh, I think that the problem with that is the chorus comes in so late, so I'm like... Oh, well done. Okay.
I am surprised that I got that before you learned.
I think I paused it again. I don't want to look, but there it is. Oh, it's London Grammar. It's Non-Believer by London Grammar.
Yes. It is what by who?
Non-Believer, London Grammar. They do the really good cover of that Chris Isaac song, Wicked Game.
Okay.
No?
No, but I'm just... More? Yeah, maybe.
It's a pretty slow start.
But there's also just like...
We both know that too.
Nope.
What a love. Interesting. Okay, I played that quite a lot.
That song.
This album.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yikes. But also, like, I'm really bad with names, so you can
list
titles.
They're quite, yeah.
I just...
They do the Hey Now.
Oh, okay.
That's them.
Okay, okay.
Cool.
Moving on.
I still hear
Cascada.
Voice every time we touch.
Yeah.
The remix. Nice. So they played at our Freshers Week. Or she? They?
She. Yeah, I think it's just...
that's the Nightcore remix. Because faster is better.
We did have that in the last playlist as
did
well.
Did it?
As well, yeah.
Interesting. Okay.
I'm pretty sure, yeah. Because we did talk about Cascada. Or did we talk about... Oh, we also had Naked.
I'm feeling sexy.
Yeah,
because I can't pronounce that word.
We didn't talk about that.
No.
But now
the X sound is really hard to do.
Sexual.
No, that's what I say. Sexual.
Yeah, it's a K and an S-H.
See, I don't like words that take too much effort to say, so like all my THs come out as Fs just because it's less effort.
Oh.
So like four. Like,
four.
I can pronounce it properly, but it's so much easier to say four. And most people know what you're trying to say. So it's fine. It's like sexual. I'm like, it's way easier to like CKS rather than like CKSH.
Sex.
So sexual rather than sexual with like a CH even actually.
No.
S-E-H.
I think ksh is easier to make because you don't actually have to put your tongue up for the X.
Sexual. I don't
sexual.
For X either.
Interesting.
Sex.
Let us know what you think.
Sexual.
Sounds flies. Like, no.
Sounds weird to me.
Sexual. Just sexual. Whereas yeah, that, you really sexual. Have to like pinch your tongue at the back. Sexual.
But that's what they say in the song. So who am I to disagree
who
with
who are
that?
We to judge? Sure. Moving on.
That was a fun discussion.
Oh, Pendulum. The Tempest?
No.
Well, it's Pendulum. It's definitely Pendulum.
Mm.
Saw you the other day. It's the Tempest.
Yes. Okay.
Classic.
No, I wouldn't have gotten that.
Fair. They're close to it, though, so Ghosts and Stuff is Rob Swire from Pendulum.
Ah,
and
yeah.
Deadmau5. Similar sound. Serious, this is congratulations, PewDiePie.
Wow. I mean, don't really listen to that on repeat. It just comes up sometimes.
It just shows up every now and then.
Mm.
So yeah, that's if you're deep in the YouTube space, you'll know that was when PewDiePie lost his number one subscribed channel.
Yes. Thing.
He made a congratulatory video for the people that overtook him. That's very tongue-in-cheek. But yeah, no.
Absolutely.
It
didn't that also like bump him back up?
Or? Yeah, yeah.
Because of that music video.
I mean, it's even fair. More tongue-in-cheek. It's a good song, like.
Yeah.
I think it's bad at all. I keep clicking off our audio software, so I can't see this is working.
Hmm.
Nice.
Nice.
Right. Well, that was easy. Oh.
Oh, that's
Ghosts and Stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's Ghosts and Stuff. Deadmau5. It's the radio edit, never would have. Good song. Oh, when everybody throw your hands up in the air, come on, let's. It's Hollywood Undead. Come on down to the city avenue where we ride against the sun, the pimpin. All right? Yeah.
I would not have guessed any of that.
I mean, that's a good song. I like that.
I know this. That's the thing, though. I know the songs because they have.
They play. Yeah,
they play,
yeah.
But I just don't.
No, so I used to listen to Hollywood. That was like the start of my emo rock phase when I was
your emo 12. Rock phase.
Yeah, man, I used to straighten my hair and all that jazz.
Ugh.
Do you know this?
Well, I've definitely never seen
well, of course
any
not.
Of it.
Yeah, it's far before.
I would say I'm glad.
I think I pulled it off fine. Sure. But it was like yeah, so Hollywood Undead, Mindless Self Indulgence, then into like Slipknot, Mushroom Head, Marilyn Manson, and then
My Chemical Romance
came back out. They were too mainstream.
Too mainstream for.
I mean, I had like one of their albums.
Okay.
Like the Black Parade, because that's actually a good album. That's like proper music.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Interesting.
A side of Josh.
A long
don't
time
know.
Ago. That's like 10 years ago now.
In a galaxy far, far away.
Oh, I love it.
Oh, Sean Paul.
You just called Shake That.
Shake That. Yeah, I think.
Get busy.
Get
busy.
Yeah. Shut up, ball.
Nice.
Come and give
that's
it to
that's also
your...
in the Ski Blast.
Yeah. That's a
blast.
Good song.
Yeah.
Oh, that's old. Nice. I remember, I have very distinct memory of, like, my brother in his room, like, playing, was it World of Warcraft?
Okay, yeah.
And listening to like Sean Paul and
wow.
Shaggy. It's like very distinct.
World of
memory.
Warcraft is like proper. Like that's gamery game.
Yeah. That was him back in. I mean, he was still in high school then.
Fair.
I don't think he games.
Anymore. Was he 30? 33.
Four now. Jeez.
God. Well, as soon as you buy yourself your own house, I feel like you've video games dropped to the wayside, sadly.
That's true. Well, maybe he'll get back into it.
Yeah, to be fair, we still every night. Which
we're almost
know,
34
we
as well. You know,
we're closer to 34 than zero.
That's
Moving on. Oh, coming in hot, Hollywood Undead. Yeah, easy. I didn't notice I had another rephase of these. I guess I did.
Throw your hands up.
Shake that whiskey. I don't know.
With Patrona.
Yeah, right. That's Patron like tequila. That's same jeans by The View.
But what? That was fast. I think that's your record time.
Got the same jeans on for 4 days now. Got the Dundonian accent, same as my mum.
Okay.
It's a good song.
Right.
This could be anything.
This could be Linkin Park
live. It could be Linkin Park. I think it is. Ding, ding. It'd be crawling. But the one more. Oh, no, it's not. Belter. Yeah, Jerry Cinnamon.
Yeah. She is a belter.
It could be Linkin. I do listen to the Linkin Park live recordings quite a lot.
Mm-hmm.
But this was before, which makes sense.
It's before, yeah.
It's like good old Angus Glass region, I presume.
Yeah.
We're definitely west coast of Scotland.
Mm.
Not a bad song.
That is a good song.
Yeah.
That is a banger, as we would say.
Or a belter.
And a belter.
Oh, there you go. There's Linkin Park. Thank you, thank you. It's Encore Numb with Jay-Z. Yeah, Numb Encore.
Numb
Encore. Well done. I prefer Numb. You knew that.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, Havana by Camila Cabello.
Camila Cabello.
What a song. I love it.
Your number one song of 2018. Yeah. I love that. That's actually hilarious.
I don't know. He's just really catchy and easy to listen to.
It is catchy.
Like, it's just one of those ones you can have on in the background. You can just have a wee groove, sing along a bit, but not too much that you're, like, singing. You can just, like, groove out to the chorus.
Oh, yeah. No, it's definitely, like, it's so recognizable. And the fact that you can sing along to it, it's like not difficult to learn all the words to chorus. Yeah. And there's a lot of the chorus in
the song. It's very easy. To be fair as well, I think another thing, like, you know, when songs come out, even I'd say Old Town Road suffered from this. Because that song's short, which I think is why it did so well on the charts, because these days it's all on streaming.
Mm-hmm.
And then you just listen to it over and over and over again.
Yeah.
But sometimes, you know, when songs kind of end, like 2 minutes in, I'm like, you could just double it. Like, just play the song twice, or at least do the chorus again. Because otherwise, you're like,
yeah,
it's just done. Where's that?
I mean, that's exactly why people throw in like a 2-4 bar bridge and then just do the chorus again, just to extend it a bit.
But I think if there's any song that there's like an extended mix that's like double the length on YouTube, it's like, you should have just made the song longer or released the extended mix. I think Deadmau5, who was my most played artist last year, does that really well. So like, there's the radio edit of Ghosts and stuff, and then like the 12-minute version.
Insane, that's so long.
But there's new stuff in it as well, so it's not just like they've repeated the song 4 times. There's actually stuff, or Strobe's really good, because that's like a really slow build up. And then the long versions, I think it's close to 15, but it's just super paced and just like really building up until it
I think comes. I mean, for electronic music, that makes so much sense though, because obviously they play at like festivals and stuff, so they will have a set that runs on for an hour, so the songs get extended because they also mix into the next song and stuff. So
100%. But yeah, no, Havana banger.
Havana.
This is Django.
Django. Da da down, da da down.
Is it Unchained?
Get it on till I die. I don't know.
No. Is it Coffin? Black Coffins?
No.
No. I'm gonna go.
They would have said it by now.
Unchained.
Yeah. I wouldn't have gotten that.
Great film. You can find out more on our opinion about Tarantino in our Tarantino retrospective.
Yes.
Represent.
We don't have any things to point.
We don't
to.
Have
just,
any.
You just have to go
it'll
to
be
the
if
channel.
You click on the channel thing there, and it'll be under retrospectives.
Yes.
In the playlists.
In the playlists.
You're welcome. I spent hours making these playlists.
Hours.
A good 15 minutes.
Yes, I mean, we did spend hours making the content of the playlist, making itself.
The creation of the content within the playlist.
Yeah.
The actual playlist making is fairly quick.
It's fairly simple.
Not to know this. Ah, Rise Against.
I know the song.
Savior. I think that was in the last video as well.
I don't hate. Oh, yeah, it must have been, yeah.
It was, yeah. Okay, well, straight on then.
Oh, Good Chance, Stolen Dance. No, Down
no,
by the River.
Down by the River. Hey. I was like, that's not Stolen Dance. Another great song.
Yeah. It's just like Stolen Dance by Milky Chance. It's just such
Stolen Dance by Milky Chance.
Yeah.
Oh, I love it.
Down by
I'm
the
so
river.
Used to being like, Alexa, play Stolen Dance by Milky Chance.
Yeah. Oh, you have to be very quiet. She can hear
she
us.
She didn't hear that. That's fine. Alexa. To be fair, we just play here because it's Spotify.
Yes.
Very clever. Oh,
Bleed Out, Linkin Park. Yeah.
I was going to pause it before and I was like, I'll let him play a little bit.
I'm glad I got it from the very first chord.
Yeah, yeah. You're like, that I used to wake up to album every morning when I was like,
ooh, 8. That is a good song to wake up to.
Yeah, or that not like cause it starts jarring. With like, speeds out. I think that's the 5th track. Mm-hmm. Don't quote me on that. Yeah, I feel like this is way more music than I listen to than you. Though I do apologize.
Yeah, but that's also fair.
That's yeah. Okay.
Especially like on repeat. I don't put songs on repeat.
It's
like
I make you listen to my music on repeat in the living room.
That's fair. No, but like, that's why the songs that I do listen to would probably not come up in
this. Yes, yeah, so it's like Seed and.
Yes. That those would be the only songs. I'm curious to see Sherman. If they are, if
they might come up. Any...
Okay, we'll see. We'll see.
Evacuate the dance floor.
Isn't that Kesha originally?
No. Maybe.
I'm pretty sure the original is by Kesha.
Shall we check?
Yeah, please check.
Do evacuate the dance floor. I'm gonna put it here so I can keep Audacity running.
You have the audacity.
I think it's J-Lo or something. Oh, it's Cascada.
Is it?
Who knew?
Oh wow.
I would.
Sorry.
Per Kesha. Alright.
The dance floor.
That's pitch perfect, guys. I'll put some like auto-tune on that. And
no. My voice is so good.
You are taking singing lessons at the moment, to be fair.
I am taking singing lessons. Wow. By none other than...
My aunt.
Your aunt.
This is what happens when you let people in the family Zoom chat. It's like, oh, what's everyone doing? And you're like, oh, you know, singing coach, whatever. Let the rest of them do, I don't
and
know.
Then Jonas was like, yeah.
Like, oh, I'll ping your wee message. I was like, oh dear. So now I have to put up with opera singing every week.
Once a week. It. Yes.
Yeah, but then you practice it's not opera. Constantly. It's pretty operatic. The Phantom of the Opera is there. To be honest, that's a good song.
I've definitely not sung that.
I like that song. I might be on this, actually.
I don't think I could pull that off.
Gerard Butler.
Like, can you see me as the Phantom of the Opera?
Half the face, no beard, yeah.
Hmm.
Maybe.
Maybe.
You're small enough to hide up in the rafters.
Mm. That is true. It wouldn't be difficult to like suspend me from anything. No.
To be fair, I remember watching that film as a kid and being horrendously bored. Like it is not about what I thought it would be about at all.
Like a phantom.
Of the opera, yeah. Like, at least some like murderer that's hiding in like the opera house killing people or something. No. I watched it and I was like, oh, okay, the intro song's pretty good. And you're like, what is this movie? This is utter crap. Mm. I'm sure it's great now, but my opinions of it as a 10-year-old have ruined it for me.
Oh, and once something is ruined that way, like, it's hard to get back into it.
Like, why would they call it the Phantom of the Opera? And he's like a mask, it's like a murderer. No. Ruined. Weird romance in an
but
opera
there
house.
You have the musical. You're...
There's no musical prejudice there. I didn't like the film as the film. Like, I saw Sweeney Todd knowing full well what it was and really enjoyed it.
Enjoy it, yeah.
Yeah.
Sweeney Todd's good.
I like Sweeney Todd. But, yeah. Whew.
Oh, that makes me think we could do a Tim Burton.
We could do a Tim Burton thing.
Yeah.
Whew, we're going to come out of that very depressed.
Yeah.
And as kooky as anything. Maybe not.
Maybe one, like,
to be fair, actually, I was just thinking, when I watched Sweeney Todd, I didn't know it was a musical.
Oh, before going into it.
Yeah, I just watched it and I was like, wow, okay, they are singing.
Uh-huh, yeah.
But it was fine. Because they still talk.
Oh, there's plenty of talking. Like, it's not a very heavy...
No, and it's not like they break into musical number. Like, I think it all feels very natural the way they're singing. There's bits where you're like, okay, no one would sing that, but it's like, okay, it's self-reflection or, like, someone advertising their wares or whatever.
Yes. No, there's definitely, like, the... You could definitely just take out the songs...
It would work fine.
And just add a piece of dialogue, like monologue most of the time.
Yeah, 100%.
Yep.
Oh, hello, hello. We live, we love, we... Oh, God.
I was singing this just before we started recording. That's the one I was singing.
Were you?
Yeah. Is it just hello, hello? We live, we love, we lose.
We live, we love, we do.
Yes, we know how it goes.
I'm trying to figure out. It doesn't say that.
I think that those are all the words you went
through.
Who's
it by?
I don't know.
It could be something obscure like Fat Rat.
What?
I think it might be. Oh, it's Alan Walker.
The Spectre.
No, Fat Rat's fairly... Definitely has some...
I've never heard that name.
This is the thing. I didn't until, like, I guess 4 months ago or something. And then it turns out there's a bunch of electronic music that I know relatively well. And I was like...
Oh, it's all by...
It's all by this guy.
Fat Rat.
Yeah, some French composer, I think. Or composer, I don't know what you call him. Electronic musician.
Yeah, DJ.
But not like a DJ, though.
Not like DJ Khaled.
Not like a disc jockey.
Yes, I mean... DJ is a very, very
well, this, broad term. It was interesting, because there was someone who was on, like, a review of electronic festivals.
Mm-hmm.
YouTube holes at 2 in the morning, I'm sure. But it was like, is there any DJ that plays, like, only their own music on their sets? And the guy was, like, very quickly like, oh, no, Deadmau5 does. And I was like, oh, yeah, sure, I get that. And he was like, but anyone else? And he was like, And of course, I don't really know the electronic scene that well. So I was like, I mean, I'm sure they sample.
There must be some. But, like... Big guys like Steve Aoki that don't do anything other than...
Their own music.
Presumably, yeah, and
I don't know.
And, like touring on festivals and stuff. They must have, like... Does.
Yeah, it's interesting, though, because there's a lot of, like, sampling of other songs in sets, for sure. But, yeah, I don't know. Just another thing why Deadmau5 is cool. I would... Yeah, I don't know why I didn't get that. I do listen to that quite a lot, but... Totally lost. Oh my god, this is
Oh no, Tattoo, all the things you said.
All the things you said.
Is that actually the title of the song?
Yeah. All things she said. Love it.
That is also such a throwback.
That's like, what, 97?
Yeah. Wow. Good music video, though.
I had the music video on, like, the iPod in the car, like, the old school...
Swirly wheel iPods.
There was like 4 songs that there were music videos for because it came like free with the song.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I had no idea what it was about as a kid. I was just like, it's raining. There's that guy with black eyes at the start of it.
Literally, very that's creepy. All I remember.
Yeah. And then they were like, oh no, but it's the other people behind the cage and they're free. That's my tummy rumbling. Yeah, I don't have a lunch. It's fine. Food delivery is coming tomorrow. All the things you said, all the things you said, running through my head, running through my head.
Is that The Weeknd as well?
No. This is Into the Spider-Verse.
Oh, yeah.
It's the one that he sings in it as well. I have no idea. Any clue? You lurked.
No, it's not playing.
Okay, Sunflower, Post Malone.
Oh.
I wouldn't have gotten that in a million years.
Yeah, like if you would have played it. I'm a bird,
cause I'm a sunflower. Okay, yeah, fair. Okay, that's sunflower. I would never have guessed that's Post Malone.
No.
Fair, good for him. That's a good song. Again, if you've not seen Into the Spider-Verse, check it out.
Brilliant film.
Great music, great film, good visual style.
Even if you don't like animated movies, like
you will or Spider-Man, probably. To be fair, you'll probably like the film regardless.
Yeah.
Good film. Yeah, it falls like rain.
Oh. That's not the name, though.
No, it's not.
Netzwerk.
It's Netzwerk, isn't it?
Yeah.
Who sings that?
I don't know who sings it. Klangkarussell.
What?
Klangkarussell. I don't know who sings it, though.
Klangkarussell? Oh, I don't know. That'll do the artist.
Do you know Zontanz? I think that's their most famous.
Oh, this is their most famous song.
Maybe now.
Okay.
But I think that they got famous through Zontanz.
Okay, fair. I don't know that song. I only know
this. All the Germans will know this.
Fair. Well, this is the thing. Like, I know that song, but I always get it mulled up with other ones. So, like, I know the song exists. And I'm like, oh, it's Netzwerk. Then I'm like, oh, wait, no, it's not. Then when it actually comes up, I'm like, hey.
Yeah.
But yeah. Okay. Fair. Right. Oh, Just Another Boy Band by the Midnight Beast. Oh, wait, maybe? Yeah, it's Just Another Boy Band. No, it's Begging.
You lose.
I know. They're very similar. They've got like 3 songs in that album that are just the same melody. Not the best music. Okay. Go, the Chemical Brothers.
Yeah. I got nothing.
Yeah, the Chemical Brothers. We found out you don't know who the Chemical Brothers are the other day. They've got like a few big songs.
Mm-hmm.
For sure. I don't know what sounds like. Like, I say they got big songs, and of course you just forget all of them instantly. Oh, Hey Boy, Hey Girl. galvanized. Dun, 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 dun.
Sure.
Okay, fine.
No, it's again a thing where, like, I probably have heard these things, but hey boy, hey girl doesn't ring a bell.
Hey boy.
Nope.
Hey girl.
Nope.
Never mind.
That's Linkin Park.
This is crawling.
Yeah.
Good, the good
That's
version
a
of this.
Good version, yeah.
Yeah. That's live. The One More Night, One More Light. One More Light Live. So that came out after he died.
Mm.
By like 5 months, I think. They released that recording because they did this for. Oh, the guy from Audioslave. Chris. Something? He did the Casino Royale theme. Okay. Well,
I don't know names.
He died. They did this festival for him. Or this show. And then like 2 months later. Sad. Chester Bennington.
That's very, very sad, yeah.
Chris Cornell. That's the guy's name.
Okay.
So, yeah, he died. So they did this for him because they were close friends. It's nice. It's heartfelt. Yeah.
No.
Great song.
It is a great song.
So's this. Started out. It was a Friday night. We walked alone. What's my age again? Blink 182. Is it?
Yeah.
Good song.
And then I turn on the TV.
Oh, that's like the age of music that are just, it's just funny.
Oh, yes.
It's
I
like
love this kind of music.
She Hates Me by whatever.
Your father
and hurts
me.
Yeah, but like songs are just like a joke. Even like Stacey's Mom, I guess.
Yeah,
but like just songs about the most stupid thing ever in punk rock form.
But it's good music,
it's
you know?
Great music. Yeah, I love it.
No, I do love it. It's when the music is good enough that the lyrics actually don't have to make any sense. Really.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I would, yeah, there's a lot of music like that.
Mm.
But speaking of that, Sam, Good Time by Hull City, I accidentally clicked.
Oh, yeah. What?
I didn't mean to press play by it. Like,
that's insane. I mean, I did hear it, but like.
I mean, how does it start? I think that's fairly distinct. We don't even have to try. Oh!
Ooh.
This is a remix. It's the Nero remix. I think it's the remix of Ghosts and Stuff.
Yeah.
I think it's the Nero version. They've got a really distinct sound. Like the big drops.
Big drops.
Big drops. So they do.
Yeah, that's true.
I Got a Crush on You, and they've got another super famous, Promises.
Mm hmm.
The other one? No?
Sure.
Can't sing it. It's way too high.
No, I was just thinking like, oh, they have big drops, like, and then, but you can't sing drops, like. Oh, yeah.
And they also do a 2808, whatever song that is. Crush? They did it in a trailer for Borderlands.
I realize I'm making this very difficult.
Yeah, you are. Especially because you do know all these songs.
I do know all the
Doomsday.
Songs.
Doomsday. That's like their. It's like a minute and a half of build up for one drop.
That's cool.
It's great.
I appreciate that.
It's really cool. But yeah, their sound, like all their remixes are very distinct on other people's songs. So.
That's cool.
Which is nice. I do like when you can tell who's the artist by, especially with like electronic music or even classical music, because they share a lot of the same features.
Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
Cool. This is Schindler's List.
Yeah. The theme from Schindler's List.
I mean, that is titled by John Williams.
Yes.
Have you seen it?
The film?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You've seen all of it?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, cool. No, I know a lot of people
that's
that
definitely not a film where I just would want to stop at half point.
I know a ton of people that stop halfway.
Oh no, that's really depressing.
Yeah,
man.
I know.
That's really depressing, man.
I know a ton of people that stop, like, as soon as they start getting into the camp stuff.
Oh. I mean, yes. But also no.
No. I, to be fair, I thoroughly enjoy that film. I think it's really well made.
It's really well made.
I don't enjoy the film, but like I have definitely watched it more times than most people I know anyway.
It is, I think just also because it is such a difficult topic.
Yeah, I think it deals with it really well.
That's what is so impressive about it.
I don't, genuinely don't think it's that, like obviously messages like that are very easy to be very obvious about, but I think it does it in such a way, like, I mean, Boy in the Striped Pyjamas, it's very, very clear
yeah
that, like, the film isn't about the characters really. Yeah. It's like the innocence versus the horrific stuff his dad's doing.
Yeah.
And then the pianist is just... Have you seen The Pianist?
No, I haven't.
No. I tried watching it because I was like, I mean, people talk about it. Yeah. I like Adrian Brody as an actor, surprisingly, because he's not in very much. But yeah. I do like his performances are always really good.
Uh-huh.
He's so upsetting. Mm-hmm. Like the whole thing, you're just like, oh man,
mm-hmm.
this is tough. Whereas I think Schindler's List does have that kind of relatability to its characters in enough places that you kind of, not sympathize, but you understand each character mm-hmm. more than just evil.
Yeah.
And innocence. You know, there is a kind of...
I think that makes things way more powerful as well, because just to paint it black and white, it's so easy to...
Literally black and white.
Yeah, but it's so easy to discard evil as
evil. Yeah.
And I think that's also just in a very real terms, I think that's dangerous.
Because... Yeah, because this is people. It happened.
Yeah.
You know, and the motivations behind it were personable, not just let's kill everyone. There was actual thought going through it. Mm. So yeah, no, really powerful movie. Mm. Definitely worth a watch if you haven't seen it. I don't think it's... I mean, sure, it's sad, but it's not like horrendous. I think it picks itself up pretty well.
I think...
Like, in terms of, like, watchability in quarantine.
Yeah.
I don't think I'd avoid it, per se.
It's definitely not, like, horrific in terms of horror films or, like, slasher or any of that.
No. But in terms of, like, mood at the end, I think The Pianist was way worse.
Mm-hmm.
In terms of, like, this is just depressing. Liz's mm-hmm. character is going from bad to worse to worse to worse.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas at least Schindler's List is about saving as many people as possible.
Yeah.
You know, there's an element of that.
And yeah. No, it definitely, there's a lot of hope in the film, and I think that's what carries it, for sure.
So I think it's powerful in that regard, but I'd watch something else after, like something a bit more chill. But like, it's not one that I'd be like, okay, you need to mentally prepare for a week to watch this movie, which those films do exist. Like, you know, where you're like, okay, right, we're going to watch this once.
Mm-hmm.
You have to see it. I mean, you have to do that for like Chinatown or Godfather, because they're so bloody long.
Yes.
That's a different kind of preparation, but even that would be like, oh, should I watch it? I'm almost like... You could watch Goodfellas.
Yeah.
You know?
Like... Oh, but that's with so many films. I mean, that's exactly my problem with watch lists, because, like, so many good films, but you're most of the time you're not in the mood for, like, the good films just because they're so heavy.
Yeah, like, oh, I mean, that's why, like, we've been meaning to watch Blade Runner for a while, but that is 2-3-hour-plus films, pretty much, that are both very slow and photographic. And they're great. I mean, the first one's great for its time, and the second one holds up pretty well. Like, obviously it holds up, it only came out 2 years ago, but, like, is a good movie, but it's so long and meandering, and they feel long, like, nothing happens.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. Another song. Film's done, but we have time, so I thought we could do another playlist.
Another playlist?
I mean, we've got I have a movie classical playlist.
Oh!
So we could test our movie themes.
Oh, you're definitely going to be better, but, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
We're going to look that way. I can't navigate this. Hang on.
It's fine. Okay. I mean, the first one is just going to be the first one anyways.
It's meant to be playing. There we go.
It is playing. I don't know if you guys can hear, but it's very low.
It's very low. Oh, I do know this.
That sounds like Pirates to me.
It is. It's the third Pirates film. I think...
Is it the song the kid sings? No.
No. That is really quiet. Sorry if you can't hear that. Doom, doom. I'm just like... I don't know.
It's just the style. Like, that sounds like the drone... bass note just sounds like Pirates to me.
Oh, it's Harry Potter.
Oh,
I should have known that as well. Oh, so statues is their big one. That was Lily's theme.
Oops.
It's a very similar style, actually. Though. Oh, I don't. I that. Did, I... No. It's because there is the not like the. Dun, 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 dun,
yeah.
But like the slower songs in the third film are very similar.
Mm.
But no, I could have guessed statues, but that I'm... Whoops. Moving on. Oh, yep. Voice. Next. Oh.
Oh man, I'm not gonna get that. Yeah, it's.
I have no idea!
Oh, this is hard.
I mean, it doesn't go anywhere. That's what not... is it? Newt says goodbye.
Oh my god.
Fantastic Beasts. This is on shuffle, Fantastic I think. Fantastic Beasts.
Right. That sounded so familiar, but I've yeah, only I've seen really Fantastic seen that once. Yeah. Oh, Jesus
Christ. I think the music plays every now and then. I mean, fair. Okay, I turn this up a bit, so uh-huh. It's easier to hear because some of these start quite quiet. I'm sorry if it blasts out loud. I have no idea what's coming, so. Oh, this is way harder than I thought.
I got nothing.
I made this by hand. This isn't like a place I just picked off Spotify.
But you know all the songs.
I should.
Yeah.
So oh, I do know this. This is the Ramin Djawadi's Paint It Black, but for... Westworld. Yes! Whew. I've not even seen Westworld. I really like that
kind of... I was just about to say, I haven't seen
I've it. I've seen so like the first no half chance. Of the first season. I didn't really like it.
Wow.
I'm really impressed I got that.
Wow.
Right, that so hard. That's the guy that did Game of Thrones.
Ah, okay.
But it's a cover of the Rolling Stones, but a very well-made cover, so you can't really tell.
Mm-hmm.
All right, moving on. Oh. Avengers. Assemble, presumably, from the first one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Avengers.
The Avengers Assemble. So, yeah. We got this.
It's right now, dun, I think it's dun, more of a combined dun, dun. Effort. Or, like, you get it, or no one does.
No, we got this. American Beauty, I think. Yeah, it's American Beauty. Fuck, that's what the song's called, though. Could be anything. The Kevin Spacey film. It's just called American Beauty by Thomas Newman.
Thomas Newman.
Good for Thomas. Good for him.
Good for Thomas, yeah. Oh,
that's I have no idea. Is this Harry Potter?
No. That must also be Westworld. It's the same
composer. Must be Westworld, same composer, yeah. It's Game of Thrones.
Oh, no, it's part of the Iron Man 3 theme.
Ah, there's Iron Man 1.
One.
It's the theme for Mark 2. If you go away and listen to it on YouTube, you can hear the dun, 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 yeah. in the background. And that was 2 years before that show came out. And it's perfect. It's about 40 seconds into that track, I think.
Yeah. It's like
on the track called Mark
just 2. Below. Yeah, it's hilarious.
Actually. Same composer. So like it's not stolen, but it's interesting that he was like playing with it and was like, I can do something with that sound.
Yeah.
There's another low note.
Shimmery.
Nothing yet.
They will have to give us more than that.
Oh! Oh, I do know this. Is it Inception? I want to say it's Time... Do you have any guesses? Right, chat? Well, I was wrong.
Close enough.
My name is Lincoln from The Island, that famous Michael Bay film. Wow. That's very similar.
Huh.
It's very
I don't similar, think I've seen that film.
Good, really?
Yeah.
Oh, we need to watch it. It's Ewan McGregor and maybe ScarJo. I don't know. I don't care. Ewan McGregor. It's Obi-Wan Kenobi. But it's good. They've got like...
I don't know. I don't care. Ewan McGregor.
Ewan McGregor is...
That's what we're here
royalty
for.
Royalty from Scotland.
So much for not watching a film for the actor.
No. I wouldn't watch it because he's attractive. I watch it because he's a great actor.
Okay.
He's
Obi-Wan
Kenobi.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. I'm sure most people in my position would watch it because ScarJo's in it. If they were looking for attractiveness.
Mm-hmm.
That would make more sense. But no, I'm not going to ruin the plot. If you've not seen it, go away and watch it. It's one of Michael Bay's... I'm pretty sure it's Michael Bay anyway. It's one of his better films.
Mm-hmm.
That and Zero Dark Thirty are his best films.
Mm. Yes, yeah. Good film.
We've seen Zero Dark Thirty.
Yes.
Good film. It's up. The start.
Yeah. The very sad...
I don't think it's that sad.
No, I mean, it ends sad.
It's just
sad.
Life.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's a bit depressing, then.
I mean, yes, but, like, if you look at it that way, everyone does die, so...
See, I think I've been conditioned for that long enough that I kind of watched and went, sure, this is sad, but, like,
yeah.
It's made to make you sad, which I like to think I'm slightly less susceptible to.
Because,
like, I mean, it's just what Pixar going, or DreamWorks? Don't know. Which is it? but like,
I mean, it's
be
easy
sad,
to,
be sad,
to think,
you know?
That it is DreamWorks because of the balloons and they fly up and stuff.
I'd be curious. Should we check?
I do think it's DreamWorks.
I'm getting a DreamWorks vibe from it, but I wouldn't be surprised if it's not.
Disney Pixar.
Is it?
Yeah.
Disney Pixar is up. There you go. Yeah. Of course, it's Disney. Money grabbers.
Well, it was Pixar. Now it is Disney.
Same thing. Same company. No. I love that on Disney Plus we're like, we have Disney films, Pixar films, Marvel films, Star Wars films. Like, they're all Disney. We
they
know you
all...
own them all. You have nothing that
you
don't own.
You don't have to call it different. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. Like, it'd be weird if they had, like, or I mean, Fox is now them as well. But if they were like, oh, we've got HBO stuff, you'd be like, oh, okay, thank you for telling me that, because I wouldn't assume that.
It makes sense, like, as a category, so you can easier, like, find your
sure.
stuff more easily. But as, like, an advertisement thing, I think it feels
yeah.
a bit weird.
Actually, I do need to briefly talk about this, because we've been watching The Clone Wars on Disney Plus,
uh-huh.
right? Because you pay for it, God help you.
It's not a lot.
It's not a lot, but it's money to the second world's greediest corporation.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe third, I don't know. There is a huge like anti-Amazon movement at the moment. I'm like, look, the day they drop their customer service, I'll drop Amazon. But until then, I'm happy to pay extra. If that money goes to Jeff Bezos, if something goes wrong with the product...
Mm-hmm.
that it can be returned, no questions asked. Like,
oh,
Amazon's return play
is
great. Is I don't want to deal with some small indie firm, like, buying direct from them if I can buy it from Amazon and just not deal with that firm's return policy.
Mm-hmm.
I'm happy to pay the premium on that. I don't mind that.
I'm pretty sure
Jeff
that's
Bezos
why they are
than
successful.
Me. Yeah, no, for sure.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But, I mean, they've got the cash flow they can suck that up, but people are like, oh, no, buy direct from the seller now. And I'm like, just
mm-hmm.
buy off Amazon. That would be
mm-hmm.
weird.
Disney
yeah,
Plus,
the
though.
Disney Plus,
yeah.
So it doesn't play the next episode until pretty much the end of the credits. And the credits are long in pretty much everything, so that's irritating.
Mm-hmm.
If you back out, it's fine, it takes you there. But when you first launch Disney Plus, if you click on Continue Watching Clone Wars, it takes you straight to the episode you've watched. And if you go, okay, no, that's the wrong episode, I'll back out to the Clone Wars page, it just takes you straight back to the home screen. So then you've got
instead,
to scroll...
Yeah.
down, but of course the next thing is because you've watched Clone Wars, so it doesn't come up there because it is Clone Wars. You have to scroll down like four things to just the normal Star Wars section, scroll along till you find Clone Wars again, and then find your episode and season every single time.
If you are confused by all this, because I am confused and
really?
I have been there and seen you do this.
Yeah, you've
that's
seen me do
it. Because
it
is confusing.
It's confusing. It's a mess. It's an utter mess. When I found out, I was like, this is insane. And even if you launch it, so, like, we're doing it on PlayStation because it's just
yeah.
a better interface than TVs. I feel sorry for anyone that doesn't have, like, an NVIDIA Shield, a Chromecast, a PlayStation, Xbox. If you're using, like, your TV's interface, do something with your life.
Mm.
Like, that's awful. Buy anything else. Like, they're just so slow.
Yeah, most of them are not,
it's so
not very
horrific.
Good.
And, like,
TVs.
Samsung TVs. So, we've got two Samsung TVs in the flat.
Mm-hmm.
Both of them come preloaded with adverts that you just can't get rid of. It's like, you want to watch Star Wars? Buy it on the Samsung store. No, I do not. But thank you for advertising
yeah.
to this me every single day. But that's
mm.
fine.
Mm.
But no, so if you launch it from like, so you get like Disney Plus and there's like, oh, you've been watching Clone Wars. Why don't you watch that? And if you do that for anything else, so Netflix, if they're like, oh, you want to continue
straight.
The heist film, whatever, Money Heist,
yeah.
or Prime, continue watching Vikings, whatever. You click there, it takes you to the episode. If you back out, it takes you to the series page.
Mm-hmm.
Disney Plus, it just takes you to Disney Plus. I'm like, continue watching Clone Wars. Yes. Here's Disney Plus for you. I'm like, Take me to the bloody thing.
Maybe they're too new and they will fix it in the future.
They have billions of dollars.
Yeah.
This stuff shouldn't happen.
Maybe they just wanted to launch their platform and it wasn't quite ready yet.
In Britain.
Yeah.
Next song.
Oh.
Indiana Jones? Maybe Star Wars? It's definitely John Williams.
It just started off with the trumpet. The trumpet with the...
Well, Harry Potter. It's Harry Potter. It's the first Harry Potter film. Yeah. Face of Voldemort.
Wow.
John Williams' sounds very distinct.
Mm.
Good for him. It was neither Indiana Jones or Star Wars, though. But we got there in the end. That's fine. My final answer. It's Braveheart. Yeah. I've never seen that film.
You have never seen the film?
It really irritates me that he's Australian. I can't get over it.
I mean, yeah.
There's so many good Scottish actors just cast a Scottish person. I get it why Americans cast British people as Americans, because we're better actors. No, to be fair, there is a whole thing of, like, Brits are, like, classically trained actors. There's a...
Okay.
Not in any, like, actuality, obviously. People are people.
Yeah.
You know? But there's a feeling, apparently, that Americans get when a Brit acts that it's, like, proper acting, apparently, in Hollywood.
Uh-huh.
That's why they get cast so much, considering we're such a small country compared to the population of America. Which I think is really interesting.
Okay.
But that's obviously no fact, but apparently that is why they get cast more.
That is interesting, because obviously when you speak of classical training, that's for theater, for stage.
Yeah. In London.
Because I think you always talk of skills as like toolboxes. It's a very different toolbox to acting for in front of a camera.
Yeah, but you get a lot of British playing American people and not the other way around. It's really rare to see an American playing a Brit.
Yeah.
And to see an Australian playing like a Scottish hero, I wasn't a fan. Just cast Gerard Butler.
Especially like in such a nationalistic thing.
Yeah, it's all about
to then have someone. I mean, the amount of
people quoting like freedom when the Scottish independence thing came around is ridiculous. I'm like, this film's not Scottish.
Yeah.
But fine. Oh, it's like Papers, whatever. Tom Hanks film. I think.
Papers?
I don't know, it's some spy film, I think. Maybe. I might be completely on the wrong track.
I don't know the song.
What is it? Scanning the Papers! The Post, John Williams.
Wow. I haven't seen that film.
Neither. It's a good song, though. Good song. I was really impressed with that. Well done, me. Oh, I know this as well.
That's that's definitely Hans Zimmer.
Could be Interstellar.
I'm pretty sure it's Interstellar.
It's Interstellar. First Step.
Yeah.
Nice. Hey. Well done, us. Very nice. This is way harder than the normal songs. So let me just run to the lyric.
Yeah.
Oh.
That sounds very similar. That sounds very similar.
It could be Interstellar again? Think it is?
I mean, that would be my guess.
I'm not sure. Okay. I'm happy to go with that. I'm not sure it is.
Ooh.
Was it Imitation Game? Yeah, okay. This is Alexander Desplat. Same guy that did the last Harry Potter films.
Mm. That's a good film as well.
Really good film.
Yeah.
Watch it, Benedict Cumberbatch.
Yeah.
I mean, that's his name.
That's from... is it the second one?
It's Hunger Games.
Yeah.
It's The Hanging Tree.
Yeah.
Something like that. Yeah, Hanging Tree. Mockingjay, whichever the one that is.
No, that's the third one.
I've not seen that film. I don't know why that's on that playlist, actually. I must have put it there. Maybe accidentally.
Is it? No, that is the third one.
Catching Fire be the second one?
Yeah.
I have read them all
as well.
I didn't make it for the last one.
Yeah, the last one is definitely a difficult read.
I think I got like 4/5 in, and then was just like, nope, I don't care. I'm not like you, or not yeah. that. You know when like you stop reading for a night, you go to sleep, and then you wake up, and then you do something else the next day, and you kind of miss it.
Mm.
And then the day after, you're like, oh, I gotta read. Then you're like,
it was definitely a thing of like, I've started the series, and I've started the book.
Yeah. I mean, that's how I felt with, so I tried playing for Vampyr, and that game is so slow, and the dialogue is not well done at all. And I was like, okay, and the action's nothing special. It's an interesting idea,
yeah,
but it's not really fleshed out well. And I played it for like 5 hours, and then it was becoming like a chore. I was like, oh, yeah, I really need to sit down and play it. And I was like, you know what? No. I'm just going to Google the ending.
Yeah, you don't have to.
Like,
yeah.
There's no need. And then actually watching the end cutscene, I was like, thank God I skipped this, because it's like 40 minutes of...
Not rewarding.
Like, repetitive dialogue, because it's like dialogue options, but they keep repeating the same things in each option. It was a nightmare. So I was like, I'm glad I skipped it. Interesting idea. I'll wait for the next game.
But same with Hunger Games. I mean, not an original idea, but interesting.
Yeah, she got sued for that. Yeah. Well, that's Suzanne Collins. So it's still Battle Royale, Japanese film. Brilliant movie. Worth checking out. It's very, very, very violent.
Mm.
There is a larger plot there, I'm sure.
No, but surely an interesting... idea, but like by the third book, it's just
well, this is what I don't get. Like, if you take so, I mean, Battle Royale, I feel, deals with it way better. If you take a bunch of teenagers, they're like 16 to 18, and put them on an island or a dome or whatever it is in Hunger Games and say, all kill each other, there's gonna be some weird, sadistic people that go on a murder spree. There's gonna be people trying to survive, and then there's gonna be that weird couple that are just like, I'm gonna find a lighthouse and, you know, get it on. And I think Battle Royale is way more realistic in that regard. If you put a bunch of hormonal teenagers in an island together and then start killing them, how that would go, rather than Hunger Games, where it's like this weird kind of love triangle government thing.
Yeah.
I don't know what's going on there.
Yeah.
And it's like, oh, we've got the berries, we'll kill each other. Like, if their eyes are gone, I'm just like, all right, do it. What are you gonna do? Die. We're literally, the whole point of Hunger Games is you're like watching their for entertainment, whereas at least Japan's one, Battle Royale, is for population.
Do.
Well, yeah, but like the Battle Royale is about population control, so they're like, we are happy to kill all of you if you want, play our game and you win. If you don't, you die.
Yeah. Fine. Everyone dies. Yeah.
Hunger Games, it's like, oh no, this is for entertainment, and yes, to control the districts, but like, it's for the entertainment. So if I was like, oh, the two lovers are going to kill each other, or you let them both live,
that would be super entertaining.
Do it. I want to see you die for each other. That'd be so great. But no. So, missed a treat there. But hey-ho. This is another low bass note.
This is definitely Inception.
It is Inception. Yeah, nice. Time. Well done. Well done indeed. See, you said I was better at this. There's no way. I've got my Kabir
Cabello down. It's time, so it's, it starts with a... Yeah.
Oh. Some Harry Potter.
Yeah, I would have guessed that.
I don't know which one. I'm not checking. Dumbledore's Army. There you go.
Ooh.
The fifth one, I guess. Presumably. Good.
I don't know if it plays there already. Oh, it must.
Well, it must, because it's
when he...
Dumbledore's Army. When... No, it's the sixth one. Half-Blood Prince, yes, sick when he dies. It's Dumbledore's Farewell.
Oh, yeah, okay. Any guesses?
I've got no idea.
I think we should let them guess this one.
Yeah, okay. Do you want the main...
But what's funny about this, Josh?
Now, actually, I know what you want me to say, but I'm going to go on an actual tangent.
Okay.
So that film is very associated, obviously, that film, that song, with Darth Vader.
Mm-hmm.
And everyone remembers him walking on Tantive at the start of episode 4 to that music.
Yes.
That song isn't in the first film.
Yes.
I think that goes to show how, in like a trilogy, you can make super impactful music like later on in the trilogy, which... If we look at a different Star Wars trilogy, didn't manage to do, because they set up their themes in the first one, or the seventh one, not giving away which trilogy I'm talking about, and then didn't really do anything with those themes, and they just kind of play when the characters come in, whereas actually you kind of, like, you've got Duel of the Fates in episode one, you've got the Anakin love theme, which is actually pretty good, like, as far as songs go, it's a bit slow and not Star Wars-y, but, you know, it's good. And then episode three, you've got the Battle of the Heroes, and they incorporate Duel of the Fates back in, so it's like you've got circling themes but also new ones coming in. And then that's the same with the original trilogy. You've got obviously the Star Wars theme, the Hope theme, and then in the next one you've got Yoda's theme. And I'm talking, aren't I? That's fine.
You're it's definitely something you know a lot about, and you've been to concerts.
Yes, I've been to a lot of John Williams concerts.
Yeah.
I like his music. I also think,
I don't know any of these things.
If you think about the stuff we have listened to, like, so Alexandre Desplat and Hans Zimmer both have music that starts with that low rumble that you guys probably can't hear. It's like, boom, and you're like, oh, it could be this film, or this film. They all kind of sound the same. And sure, if we let the whole song play, I'm sure we'd land on it.
Yeah.
But every single John Williams one that's come up, we've been like, that's John Williams, definitely.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a case of figuring out which film, and a lot of the time that's super obvious.
But I also understand, like, making a score means that you compose something, and then you always have to change that into how it fits on the film. Like, the way we're listening to that is also going to be like, yeah, I mean, it starts with a low rumble because you want to have that section in there.
But it's interesting. A lot of them are the main themes, though, so to have that as, like...
Mm-hmm.
So, like, I mean, Star Wars doesn't really play, like, as bombastic as it does, except on the crawl.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, Imperial March, they can still make it a track.
Yeah.
It is very
noticeable. Yeah. No, as a theme, it is definitely way more distinct, but it's also because it is a march and not
that's fair.
Background.
But it's interesting how some of those themes, like, some of them are just the main title theme, but they're very, like, there's two notes going on there, maybe, and they're just like, dum-dum, with a moo in the background. Like, yeah. Anyways, sorry, did you want to talk about Mary Poppins?
No. What?
Okay, that's fine.
Mary Poppins?
Spoonful of Sugar?
What?
Never mind. Apparently Spoonful of Sugar fits in the Imperial March.
That is definitely not where I was going.
Is it not?
No, it's exactly what you said, that this, it's not in the film.
Interesting. We're on the same. I thought you were going for the... We watched a video yesterday about songs sound the same, and apparently Imperial March sounds the same as Spoonful of Sugar. I don't really hear it personally, but we did watch that video.
I did not.
Oh, interesting. Maybe I watched that on my own.
Yeah, maybe. Wow. I was like, what?
No, apparently a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down. It's the same.
Fair enough.
It fits almost perfectly. Like, lyrics can definitely work. It's not the same, but it's very close.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
That makes sense.
I'm glad we were on the same track. Wow. Is Avatar becoming the people or whatever, I think.
Yeah.
Becoming one of the people.
Wow.
There you go. Now we have hit the hour mark. I think we should just keep going. This is fun.
You want it?
Yeah, you want
it? Yeah?
You want it?
I don't know how many songs you have in that playlist.
I have no idea.
Because that could be...
We'll just keep going until we hit a point where we get bored. Because we're not bored yet. Are you bored yet? Surely not if you're still here.
Jesus Christ.
No,
that is Harry Potter.
That's Harry Potter next. Dun, 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 dun.
That must be Forrest Gump then.
It is Forrest Gump.
Yeah.
Yeah, nice.
Well done.
I'm proud of this. Well done. Yeah, yeah.
Some low brass.
Yeah, I think it's literally silent on the mic. Sorry, you can't hear that. Oh! Dun, dun, dun. Is that... I think it's one of the Avengers films. Oh, it's Batman. It's the Batman theme. It's Batman theme.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's nice. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, okay. Oh, season 7, episode 10 of Game of Thrones. Oh no, it's not episode 10, is it? Season 6, episode 10. There you go.
What?
Light of the Seven. Yes! So that's the bit when Cersei's blowing up everyone.
What?
Okay, so season 6, episode 9 is the Battle of the Bastards. And then the next episode is Cersei blowing everyone up. That's how it starts.
Okay.
It's the first time piano's used in Game of Thrones.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, yeah, that's why it's so impactful. And...
Right.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Because it immediately strikes you. It's the montage of Cersei kind of getting ready, and then she watches everyone blow up in the Great Sept.
It did not strike me as, oh, it's the first time piano is playing in Game of Thrones.
I would always say, mate. Well, I knew something was different about it, and then checked. Because it all uses medieval instruments, and the piano obviously didn't exist at the time setting of Game of Thrones, obviously, because it's fantasy, but it is set in a time.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, the piano didn't exist. That's why it's striking. There was a huge thing about, oh, should we use it or not? Because, like, it's out of place, but no, it works pretty well.
Okay.
Yeah, so if you're watching Game of Thrones and you've not seen it before, or you're rewatching it, that is the end point. you end there, because you've got Daenerys coming into the Westeros.
Mm.
Jon's parentage is revealed. I think that's when he gets crowned King of the North as well. Yep.
Mm.
And then Cersei kills everyone there. And what to do? Use your intelligent, creative brains that we've all got.
Yeah.
And make your own ending. Because no matter what you ending. Do, you could make it stupid as anything. Yeah. And it's not as bad as the real one.
Yeah. My brother just told me that his best friend bought all seasons of Game of Thrones. I was like, he made error.
Oh, 1 to 6. I actually saw a thing on Reddit this morning, and it was a guy working in a like warehouse for like, I guess the equivalent of HMV or like a DVD store.
Uh-huh.
And they have 800 copies of season 8, and they're all like covered in like this much dust. They're just sitting there. Because who's buying just season 8? Like, okay, if you buy the 1 to 8 box set, fine.
Yeah, you got it, but...
But like, who's sitting there like, you know what? I will pick that up. I'll pay money for that. No.
Don't do it.
It's terrible.
Yeah.
Jalo TV, vote with your wallets.
I mean, honestly, put that money towards...
Anything. Cocaine. It's probably better spent.
It's a better time.
It's a much better time than season 8, which is very much losing it.
We wouldn't know.
Season 8 is more like meth. I think you come out of it just... disheveled and skinny and broken.
Yeah.
We know our stuff.
Yeah.
You're the druggie, not me.
I don't know.
You've got that vibe.
Sure. I'm an actor, so maybe that
makes
sense. That's
it. You're putting it on this whole time.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah, I'm the child actor, so I must be the druggie.
I mean, I say that, but I've got like, my antibiotics just sitting right there anyway.
That's okay.
Pills a day. Throat is getting better though. You'll be pleased to know.
Yeah.
It still like weakens your like gum. So I've got like 2 cuts in my mouth at the moment, which is really annoying. It's because I keep eating crisps.
He's a joker inside.
Oh no, that's from biting my gums. But I do have like a full scar up here and here.
Mm.
And every time I go to the dentist, she's like, "Can you stop biting gums?" I'm like, I do it when I sleep. It's not my fault. I obviously don't do it as like a nervous twitch or anything. But like,
Like dentist.
It's not my fault. She's like, it can cause cancer. I'm like, it's not my fault.
There are so many things that can cause cancer.
Yeah, like, I mean, I do say to her, I'm like, I smoke like 2 packs a day, so.
Mm. So your scars are probably the least of your problems.
I don't smoke that. That'd be hell in quarantine, actually. Can you imagine living with a smoker?
Jesus.
Oh, the smell.
Lock them in their room.
Right. Violin. This could go 2 ways.
You sure that's a violin?
Yeah.
Those are my hands.
Yeah, that's what I said. Violin.
Started off with a cello.
Well, you'd know this because you're a cello player. Oh, wait, you don't actually own a cello. You just use my guitar all the time. Interesting.
Yeah, that's true.
Fair, it's my mom's guitar, actually, so it's fair.
Wow.
Yeah, I put a hole in it, though. Oops. I have no idea what this is.
Neither.
Oh!
Oh.
I think it's a war film. Could be Saving Private Ryan. I could be way off on the wrong track there, though.
It was just those 2 notes. That seemed very
Dynasty of Gold.
Nope.
Interesting.
I got nothing. But war film doesn't seem too far off.
Oh, what?
What?
It's Wonder Woman.
Yeah, that's a war film.
It is a World War One. Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah.
That's, like, not the main theme, obviously. We're not stupid. Yeah. Okay, good for them. They really got the vibe down, because I wouldn't have been able to guess that track.
Mm.
Interesting. How music can paint a picture.
Oh, yes.
Of course.
I mean, yes.
Right. Oh.
If this does not have anything to do with time, then I don't know what.
I don't know what this is. Dun 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 dun, it's Avengers. I think. It is.
It must be Endgame then.
Oh wait. Dun, 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 dun. We're really exceeding our 2 seconds related to play, but... No, it's not! Dun 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 dun. Star Trek, the first Star Trek film.
Yeah.
Cool. I didn't start. Wow. Yikes, that sounds so similar to Avengers, though. The start, it's only the main bit.
Hmm.
Interesting. It's the same build.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. I love how there was a guy just like hitting a rim. Dun 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 dun. No, for the click, oh. click, click.
Yeah,
click,
interesting. Click, yeah, like click, it doesn't matter time because they've got a tick in the back.
Yeah.
Which would make sense because it'd be like Dunkirk or Inception in that case. Both of which.
Yeah, but also the song from Imitation Game. But that was not time. That was the machine clicking. Yeah.
Interesting. Which is what always throws me off in that theme.
Yeah. No, but that's like the whole painting a picture.
This is Game of Thrones as well. This the same episode. 6:10 Yeah. It's at the end when they're on the boat. Okay. Next. Oh. If you can't hear it, that's how it went.
Some French horns.
No. It's Jurassic Park.
Yeah, I got a glimpse of the icon, yeah. So I wasn't guessing.
You got a guess what?
No, I got a glimpse of the icon. Oh,
you
see,
you need to look there when it comes up.
Yeah, I didn't just know that you press the button.
Sorry,
and that.
I'm always pressed right, okay.
Oh. That's really quiet. I know this. This is like... It's Batman.
Swelling violence. It's Dark Knight. Yeah.
Oh. Or Dark Knight Rises, maybe? I think it's Rise.
Oh!
What?
No!
No! But I mean, it's both.
They're the same. So that's the Da Vinci Code. Which I haven't actually seen.
Oh, maybe now when you let it play for a bit, like, it's going to be obvious. But the same, like, violence.
No, I mean, it's Hans Zimmer.
Yeah.
To be honest, I'd still guess Dark Knight.
Because it's the same violins going...
And they're really quiet in the background.
Wow. Well, I mean,
even now,
I would still guess. Fair enough for guessing the same composer, though.
Yeah, I mean, this is the thing. Like, okay, yeah, distinctive sound, but then at least John Williams has, like, themes, whereas that is... Like, even letting that play, I'd say that's probably the background of Dark Knight somewhere.
Mm.
Interesting. Dark Knight only has the Rise, which is the track in the Rises.
Yeah.
Which is like the theme.
Yeah.
And the rest of it is just the kind of background stuff.
Score, yeah.
Wow. Again, really quiet.
I know the song. Oh, that's so annoying, you know.
It's historical for sure.
Yeah.
I got nothing, you got any ideas?
I'm tempted to like, it feels like Lord of the Rings, but I'm... No, it's not.
Gladiator.
See, we should have seen that.
We should have just said
watch that film.
We should have watched Gladiator. We would have got it. Wow. Okay. Again, Hans Zimmer. All his songs sound the same. Right. Should we make this our last one?
Yes.
As long as it's a good one. If it's crap, okay. I'm sorry. Oh fuck. I know this as well.
Some choir and some drone. Sounds like Hans Zimmer to me, to be honest.
Oh, okay, this is Band of Brothers.
Oh.
Whew.
That's not him.
No. That's good for them.
Yeah, good for you.
Well, yeah.
For guessing
good,
that.
Good for me for
I
guessing.
I haven't seen all of it, so.
Yeah, I was just thinking that we should finish it. Because I would say Band of Brothers is...
The most?
I'd say the best.
The best?
10 episodes? Like one season of anything I've ever seen.
Mm-hmm.
I'm willing to put my money on that, I think.
I think that's fair.
Like, there's no...
There's not a lot. That's just, like, 10 episodes.
But this is the thing. If you think about films, like... So compared to, like, Fury, which I think takes a mm-hmm. pacing dump in the middle of the film when they're in that house for way too long, and it's mm-hmm. all a bit weird and kind of rapey. I don't know.
Yes.
Gets odd. And Saving Private Ryan, as soon as Matt Damon comes in, nothing against Matt Damon as an actor or anything like that, but that marks the point the film turns into like Hollywood.
Yeah.
And like they're starting using like sticky bombs with socks and oil or whatever against the tanks. And it's like, for something that has been so realistic up till that point, it kind of just dives. And then on the other end of the spectrum, if you've got something like, well, Game of Thrones takes a pitfall at the end, or Walking Dead has died, I think there are weaker parts of Black Sails even. Mm-hmm. There's definitely, I think season 4 is the weakest season. That, not to say that the season is bad, but it's not as strong.
Yeah.
Whereas I think Band of Brothers, every single episode is brilliant. Like, it is consistently exceptional. And for 10 hours of TV, that's so, so good to do.
Time well spent.
Yeah, so we should actually finish that.
Yeah. Shall we do that right now?
We could do that right now. I think, yeah, good place to end it. If you've not seen it, it is on Now TV, I hope, still, on Sky. So you can take out a week's free trial or whatever, 2 weeks, and watch it.
It's watch all it on.
Online as well. but yeah, no, I hope you enjoyed that as much as we did. Yes. I think a lot of the movie themes were quite quiet, so I'm sorry if they didn't come out very well.
We can maybe put them in the description for you to listen to as well.
Well, you can hear one.
Oh, yeah.
We hear, because otherwise they have to click on it and they know straight away.
That's true.
Yeah, so I'm sorry if you can't figure it out, but it's definitely a bit more fun for us because...
More challenging, for sure.
Way more challenging.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's interesting. But yeah. No,
that's it for today.
That's it for today. Thanks for watching. Thanks for tuning in all the way till an hour and 16 minutes, or whatever it is, because that's cool. We were just having too much fun and didn't want to stop.
Exactly.
But now, I'm just peeing. That's the stop.
On that note.
Cool. Yeah, we will see you tomorrow. Have a good one. Bye!